अब मैं आपको बताऊंगा रिफ्रैक्शन थ्रू स्फेरिकल सरफेस। ये फार्मूला बोथ पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से काफी इंपॉर्टेंट है। दिस फार्मूला इज डिराइव्ड अंडर थ्री अजम्पशंस। नंबर वन, ऑब्जेक्ट इज टेकन एज अ पॉइंट ऑब्जेक्ट, इट इज कैप्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ द सरफेस ऑन प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस। दूसरा है, एंगल मेड बाई इंसिडेंट रे एंड रिफ्रैक्टेड रे विद द प्रिंसिपल एक्सिस आर टेकन वेरी स्मॉल। थर्ड इज, अपर्चर ऑफ द सर्फेस इज टेकन वेरी स्मॉल। लेट्स सी वॉट इज देयर इन द फिगर। दिस इज अ पॉइंट ऑब्जेक्ट, इंसिडेंट रे हिट्स ऑन द सर्फेस एट पॉइंट एम एंड गेट्स रिफ्रैक्टेड एंड फाइनली इट फॉर्म्स एन इमेज एट आई डैश। एंड सी इज द नॉर्मल, सो सी इज द सेंटर ऑफ कर्वेचर ऑफ दिस सर्फेस। This is distance of an object, this is distance of an image, this is radius of curvature. So we are going to derive basically a relation between u, r and v. So according to Snell's law, we know Snell's law, refractive index of this side medium is mu 1, other side is mu 2. So mu 1 2 is equal to sin I over sin r. For a small angle theta tends to 0, sin theta tends to theta, this shows mu 2 over mu 1 is equal to I over r. Cross multiplying it, you will get mu 1 I is equal to mu 2 R. This is your equation number 3. Now from the triangle OMC, I is equal to, we can write tan alpha plus tan gamma. We know that I is an exterior angle. Of this triangle, so sum of opposite angles alpha and gamma can also be written in terms of tan value because angle is taken very small. Similarly, from triangle CMI, you can write R is equal to tan gamma minus tan beta. This you can say 4A and 4B. So continuing here, in this case what we have to put the values of tan alpha, tan gamma, beta and tan gamma. From triangle, right angle triangle MBO, you can get tan alpha is equal to MB over OB. From triangle MBC, you can get tan gamma is equal to MB over BC. And from right angle triangle MBI, you can get tan beta is equal to MB over BI. This you can say 5A, 5B, 5C. Now put the value of 4A and 4B in equation 3. 4A and 4B in equation 3. What was equation 3? Mu 1. So you will have mu 1 I means tan alpha plus tan gamma is equal to mu 2 and then tan gamma minus tan beta. Fine. Now put the values of these values also here. tan alpha, tan beta, tan gamma. So mu 1 tan alpha is mb over ob plus this is tan gamma mb over bc, mu 2 mb over bc minus mb over bi. Mb mb gets cancelled, and for a small aperture ob it tends to op and bc tends to pc and pbi tends to pi. So this equation will become equation, this equation will turn to mu 1, 1 over OB is OP plus 1 over BC is PC, mu 2 this is 1 over BC is PC minus 1 over PI. Now you can put their values with proper sign convention. OP is minus U, PC is R, mu 2 PC is R minus 1 over V. Rearrange the terms, you will get mu 2 over V minus mu 1 over U is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 over R. This is very important relation for finding a relation, give a relation between U, V and R. This now next article we are going to do lens maker's formula. What is difference between lens maker's formula and lens formula? Lens maker's formula is used to design thin lenses. That's why it is termed as lens maker's formula. For example, a convex lens consists of two spherical surfaces. This is optical center, principal axis passing through this. This is point object, incident ray normal to this surface C. This you can say R1. The image is formed by this somewhere here, I dash, and final image is shrinked because of the surface S2 at I. There you can divide this lens into P X P1 Y P2. P1 and P2 are the poles, right? So X P1 Y X P2 Y. Fine. This is the image formed by the first surface. When you join second half of the lens, final image is formed at I. This is U, this is V, you can up till I, and this is up to I dashes. Use the formula twice. Mu 2 over V minus mu 1 over U is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 over R. For surface X P1 Y, applying this, this is similarly you can use, no problem, because there is no change in any condition. Here also refractive index of the medium of air is mu 1 and glass is mu 2, right? stand for surface xp to y. This is mu 1. You can write mu 1 over v minus mu 2 over v dash is equal to mu 1 minus mu 2 over r 2. In the second equation, you can see I have interchanged mu 1 and mu 2, mu 1 by mu 2 and mu 2 by mu 1. Of course, for second half, v dash acts as an object, so I kept v dash there. But why mu 1 is replaced by mu 2 and mu 2 is replaced by mu 1? Because for this surface, all conditions are same as we have derived in case of a spherical surface. Ray of light is traveling from rarer to denser, but in case of the second half, the ray of light travels from denser to rarer. So when you move from A mu w, as we know that A mu w is reciprocal to w mu A. That's why everything is interchanged. Now what you have to do, just add these two relations, equations 2 and 3. What you will obtain while you are adding 2 and 3, you will obtain mu 1 over v minus mu 1 over u is equal to mu 2 minus mu 1 over r 1 minus 1 over r 2. Now see, mu 1 you can take common in the left hand side. So take mu 1 as common and divide and take it in the right hand side. So what you will have in the left hand side, 1 over v minus 1 over u is equal to mu 1 2 minus 1, 1 over r 1 minus 1 over r 2. 1 over v minus 1 over u is 1 over f, focal length. So this is termed as lens maker's formula. Focal length 1 over f is equal to power. So you can say power of lens is also mu 1 2 minus 1, 1 over r 1 minus 1 over r 2. Now since refractive index, as we know, depends on wavelength, so power also depends on wavelength, focal length also depends on the wavelength. So it is very important to understand that if you have convex lens using in the lab, if you observe image of an object by changing the light color of the light radiation, the focal length will change, because we know mu v is greater than mu r, because it's a reciprocal to wavelength. And focal length here is 1 over f is directly proportional to mu. So refractive index is reciprocal to refractive index. It means refractive index of mu r is less, so focal length of f r is greater than f v. Means if you use and observe any image of an object in the lab by using red color or blue color or violet color, then while you are making calculation of focal length of the lens, the red color, in case of the red color, focal length will be more. In case of violet color, the focal length of the lens will be less. Another thing, it also varies from medium. Suppose, for example, FA is focal length of lens in air. I immerse it in water, then will its focal length change? So you form two equations. For air, you can say A mu g minus 1, 1 over r 1 minus 1 over r 2. Now when I immerse in water, then focal length in water, fw is w mu g minus 1, 1 over r 1 minus 1 over r 2. divide equation 1 by 2. Divide equation 1 by 2. You can calculate the focal length of lens in water. What you will have? When you divide 1 by 2, you will obtain FW over FA is equal to A mu G over W mu G. A mu G is 3 by 2. W mu G, when you calculate, you will get 9 by 8. So, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 here, minus 1 here. So, it is 1 by 2 by 1 by 8. What you will have? 4. So, FW is equal to 4A. So, same focal length of the same lens when you use in air or when you use in water will be different. You see, it is in calculation coming nearly 4 times. I mean to say, focal length of a given lens in air is 15 cm. So, when you immerse in water, its focal length after measuring comes out to be will be 60 cm. So focal length increases. That's why how the nature of the lens also change when you change the medium around the lens. Say for example, I can give you 3 very interesting examples. This is a convex lens in the regular usage. Mu1 refractive index is mu2. This is another convex lens I can make. Changing conditions for refractive index, mu1, mu2, and third I am making here, third condition. You see the change in the behavior of a lens. You cannot call that convex lens is always a convex lens. Mu1, mu2 is refractive index of this. In normal situation, mu1 is greater than mu2. So, the ray of light coming from here, it bends towards the normal. Converging nature of convex lens, which you define in day-to-day life, it is applicable only when outside medium of the lens is air. When mu1 is equal to mu2, the ray of light coming parallel to this principal axis moves without deviation. In this case, lens will disappear. Right? In this case, when mu1 is greater than mu2, the ray of light coming parallel to the principal axis, when it hits to this surface, drop normal. Refractive index of this medium is less. So when ray of light travels from rarer to denser, it bends away from the normal. So the ray of light will move like this. Again, you drop perpendicular on this surface, the ray of light will bend like this. So you see the quick change in the nature of convex lens. We normally call convex lenses converging in nature, but you see it is applicable only when the either bahar ka medium air hai or lens is made up of higher refractive index. Agar dono ke refractive index barabar hai, to lens medium ke andar disappear ho jayega. You cannot see the lens at all. Agar bahar ka medium ka refractive index lens ke material ke medium se jyada hai, तो यही लेंस कंकेव लेंस की तरह बिहेव करेगा. सो प्रैक्टिकली व्हाट इज कन्वेक्स लेंस एंड व्हाट इज कंकेव लेंस, इट इज ऑल इज डिफाइंड बाय द रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ द टू मीडियम. इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द शेप ऑफ स्फेरिकल कर्वेचर. यू सी यू कॉल इट एज कन्वेक्स लेंस बट राइट नाउ इट इज बिहेविंग एज कंकेव लेंस. सो रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स playing a vital role in refraction to understand. And this is also a very important question to understand the ray diagrams of this.